Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It is Hart, and today we have our first NFL slate breakdown of the season on DraftKings. $1 million to first. Super pumped, super excited. 13 games, going to be electric. Follow me on Twitter, HartDFS. And also make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, turn on the notification bell. Going to be putting out a ton of content this NFL season. Monday night football content, Thursday night football content, Sunday regular slate content, and Sunday night content as well. As well as prize pick plays for all those slates on the NFL season. So, ton of videos out every week, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Hit the like button, subscribe. Going to be epic. Now, let's get into the slate breakdown. This is going to be more of a fast one of my favorite DFS plays, picks, and value plays. Games are obviously tomorrow, so don't want to keep you guys here too long. Over the coming weeks, starting week two, I'll have more of a longer video of analysis and kind of my thoughts on the plays and the teams playing. So let's get into it. Philadelphia, Detroit. Hurts looks great, 6,800. Has that rushing upside. We'll have to see if he's going to be able to feed all three guys on the Eagles side of Goddard, AJ Brown, and Devontae Smith, but at that price looks fantastic. 6,800 against Detroit. Jared Goff, not for me. Excuse me. Swift, once again, that price from at 6,800 looks fantastic. No matter the game script, even if they're up, even if they're down, Swift will be involved, running the ball and pass catching. So really like him. The Philadelphia running back situation is just not for me. Expect Miles Sanders to have a lot better season this year. Do expect him to get a touchdown or two, at least, maybe even a touchdown tomorrow, but they have like four running backs, so not going to get to them. When it comes to the receivers, AJ Brown, don't mind taking a shot on him. I just don't trust, Jalen Hurts that much when it comes to throwing the ball, but obviously if you're going to play Jalen Hurts, it makes sense to stack him with at least one wide receiver, if not two. St. Brown on the Detroit side looks pretty solid. That's really all I'd get to out of the receivers. I don't mind taking a shot on DJ Chark. It looks like a solid value play for Detroit, who should be down and they should be passing the ball a ton, so you can definitely look to him. The tight ends, Goddard looks like my favorite play on the Philadelphia side. 4,500, should get his looks, especially when you get closer to the red zone, so does have some upside there. Hockenson, just a little too injury prone for me. Played banged up all of last season. Had some good games, had some bad games, so I mean, they will be down. He is kind of the best wide receiver, I would say, behind St. Brown. So even though he's a tight end, I do think Jared Goff will look to him a lot. So just at that price, I just don't think I can get there. So not a lot of what I like in the Philadelphia-Detroit game. The Jets versus the Ravens. Lamar Jackson looks like an A-plus play, especially with how he didn't get his contract extended. Do think he's a play with a chip on his shoulder. So Loveland gets this matchup against the Jets. Running back situation is not for me. Dobbins might play, even if he doesn't. Still think, they have Drake, they have Mike Davis, Justice Hill. Just too many running backs in that situation for me to like anyone. Bateman looks decent at 5,300, filling in for Marquise Brown, who got traded to the Cardinals. So I just Bateman looks like an okay play. And then Mark Andrews looks fantastic. Going to see 10-plus targets. Pretty much going to be the only guy Lamar Jackson is going to throw to. So love him. Love Lamar Jackson. And the only guy I like on the Jets side is going to be Elijah Moore. Had a fantastic middle part of the season before he got injured. Do expect him to kind of have that same thing going into this season. Great sophomore season I do expect from him, even with Joe Flacco thrown to him. Don't really trust any of the other guys. Berrios, Corey Davis is probably starting over Wilson, so that takes Wilson out of play. I mean, they're going to be down, so we're going to have to throw a ball a ton, but I just trust them getting it to Elijah Moore. Split backfield between Hall and Carter, so not for me. Tight ends are not in play for me. New Orleans, ATL. You can take a dart throw on Winston. He does have some upside. Almost 30 against Green Bay, almost 28 against Washington. Mariota, not for me. He does have some rushing upside, but Saints defense is just too good. Kamara looks like a fantastic spot for Kamara. No matter the game script, going to be involved just like DeAndre Swift. So really like him. Not touching any of the Atlanta running backs, wide receivers. Michael Thomas is questionable. We'll see if he plays. Even if he does, don't think I'm going to get to him. I'd rather take a shot on a guy like Olave. And then tight ends, not for me on the New Orleans side, but on ATL. Don't mind getting into Drake London, 5K, should see a good amount of targets. We'll just have to see if he plays. If he doesn't, really no interest in any of these backups. Do think Kyle Pitts is going to get fed the ball. So 5,700 going to be one of the most popular tight ends on the slate. But really, once again, don't trust that New Orleans defense. Or I trust them where I don't think Atlanta's going to do much against them. New England, Miami, really not for me. You know, Mac Jones, don't really trust him as a quarterback. Not the best, more of like a game management quarterback. So don't think he can really support multiple wide receivers enough for this game. Damian Harris, Stevenson, both splitting the backfield. Stevenson is going to be that third down pass catching back. So I think that takes both out of play for me. I mean, if I was to take a shot on one, I'd say Stevenson, but not going to go there. They do have Devontae Parker, revenge spot for him, 4,800. I just don't trust Mac Jones throwing the ball deep to him. I do think he's going to stick to under, like the under routes to Jacoby Myers, kind of his safety blanket. So don't mind taking a shot on him or a guy like Hunter Henry at 3,800. He's a red zone threat. Mac Jones looks for him in the red zone. But out in the open middle of the field, he really doesn't look for Hunter Henry. So don't really have much to like on the New England side. Miami side, Tua is just too inconsistent for me. Edmonds looks like a pretty solid play, 5,200 starting back. Going to see rushing attempts. He's a great receiving back. So I don't mind getting to him. There are like four running backs behind him. Mostert, who's a bigger back that they can bring in, who's super fast. Gaskin has experience, you know, did well last year. So not going to get to any of those running backs, but you can definitely take a shot and chase Edmonds. Looks pretty solid at 5,200. Tyreek Hill, obviously very cheap for Tyreek, but once again, Tua's thrown to him. I do expect them to get him involved in, you know, multiple ways, whether that's running the ball and around, you know, little screen passes. So I do expect him to get a good amount of catches. It's just, I don't know if he's going to get those yards or touchdowns. You know, Jalen Waddle, going to wait. They're going against the good defense of New England. I do think New England's going to try to take Tua out of his comfort zone. Do think they're going to play smash mouth ball, just run the ball a ton, rely on their defense to make Mac Jones throw bad passes. So I think most of the guys on the Miami side are out for me. Gesicki, just not for me. He's not playing in the slot. He's playing more of a tight end role. So that takes his upside out. Moving on to Pittsburgh, Cincinnati. I wouldn't touch anyone on Pittsburgh besides Najee Harris at 6,400. Do think it's going to be a little bit of a regression year for him. Don't think he's going to be in as many checkdowns as he did from Ben Roethlisberger as he will from Mitch Trubisky. So I just don't trust Mitch. Not a good quarterback. Joe Burrow looks fantastic. Going to be one of the best stacks of the slate tomorrow is him and, you know, Mixon, Chase and T. Higgins. All look fantastic. But yeah, don't want to get to any of the tight ends on either side. Only wide receivers I like are obviously Jamar Chase, T. Higgins. Running backs from both sides look solid, and then the only quarterback I like is Joe Burrow. I just think Mitchell Trubisky is going to embarrass himself. Matt Ryan looks okay at 5,500. I know they said they're going to pass the ball a lot more this year, but they're not going to need it against Houston. You know, Jonathan Taylor is just going to go off. But at 9,100, you really need him to go for like two touchdowns and 125-plus yards to be in the optimal lineup. Otherwise, he's just a little too expensive. So I don't know if I'm going to get there. You know, obviously, it's a fantastic matchup against Houston, but this is super expensive. Pittman looks pretty solid. You know, number one wide receiver, has Matt Ryan, better quarterback thrown to him than he did last year. So don't mind it against Houston. I know he's going to be super popular. Don't think a lot of people are going to be playing Alec Pierce. Not a lot of news on him, but I do think he's going to be the second wide receiver. Do think he's going to have a great season. I really like him as a sneaky dart throw play at 3,900 as some value as a wide receiver too, if you want to get off chalky Pittman. Tight ends, not for me. Houston side, all I really like is Brandon Cooks. I know Damian Pierce is starting 4,800. A lot of fantasy football bros are on him, but I just don't know if we can trust him yet with having the whole workload, especially with the pass catching downs. Like, I think Rex Burkhead's going to sub in for the pass catching plays out of the backfield, so 4,800, I'd definitely take a shot on Pierce, but he's not my favorite play. And that does it for me in that game. I think, you know, Indiana is going to destroy them. Washington and Jacksonville. I think Wentz or Lawrence is a sneaky, sneaky play for tomorrow. And here's why. They have Etienne and Robinson. You know, Etienne's explosive. I do think it's going to be a split backfield, so I'm not going to get to either one. But I think with the new head coach, a new offensive coordinator, I think, you know, Trevor Lawrence is going to really flourish this year, sophomore season. So I really like him at 5,600. Not going to get to one of the running backs. I like all three wide receivers, Kirk, Marvin Jones, and Zay Jones. All super cheap. All guys are going to see a ton of volume, ton of targets. Kirk's going to lead them just because he's the number one wide receiver, but don't mind taking a shot at either of the guys behind him as well. Washington, not a fan of anyone, not a fan of Wentz this week, not a fan of Gibson. You know, if he does one thing bad, he's going to get benched. McLaurin, just a little too expensive for me in this matchup. You know, Jacksonville doesn't have a good secondary, but you got Carson Wentz thrown to you. Nothing's guaranteed. And then you could definitely take a shot on Logan Thomas. You know, he was solid last year when he played, but very injury prone, questionable. Don't think you get to do it. San Fran and Chicago. Trey Lance looks solid at 6K. I don't think he's going to throw the ball a ton. It's supposed to rain for this game, so I do think the San Francisco 49ers are just going to run the ball, pound it into the ground, and just rely on Elijah Mitchell and then Jeff Wilson when he comes in to give Elijah Mitchell a breather to do well. So really like Elijah Mitchell, 5,400. Looks like one of the best running back plays on the day. Deebo Samuel is too expensive for me in this game versus the Chicago Bears, especially if it's raining. Don't think they're going to throw the ball a ton. So that rules out Ayuk as well. Kittle is questionable, even if he does play. I just think I'm firmly only on Elijah Mitchell just because of the weather situation. Bears side, Fields, I think there's a little bit more upside in this game for him than Trey Lance just because he's going to have to throw it. The Bears are going to be down. They're not going to be able to stop the running game, so they're going to be down a bunch of points. So Fields is going to have to run it, and he's going to have to throw it. Monty should see, you know, rushing attempts as well as the pass-catching attempts, you know, pretty solid back. That price looks okay, especially with the weather. But, you know, Mooney looks firmly in play, 5,700, number one wide receiver. Was getting fed targets at the end of last year. He's going to get the same thing. I mean, the weather is going to be a factor tomorrow. Not sure how heavy it's going to rain, but I just think San Fran's going to run it. Bears are going to have to pass it. Can't really trust the Bears pass off in offense, but Mooney and Cole Kmet are too cheap for a team that's going to be behind all season and going to throw the ball a ton. So I'll definitely take a shot in those two on the Bears side. Cleveland, Carolina. Only plays I like on the Cleveland side are the running backs, Chubb and Hunt. Who would rather go with Chubb. And then tight end, Njoku. Don't trust any of the wide receivers. Brissett is not a good quarterback who throws to wide receivers. He throws to tight end. So Njoku, firmly in play at 3,900. You can definitely take a shot on you know, huge Hail Mary shot on Harrison Bryant. Because I do think they'll probably run some two tight end sets with Jacoby Brissett. But otherwise, I just stick to either Njoku or one of the running backs on the Cleveland side. Carolina side, Baker Mayfield, you know, he's going to be a lot better than Sam Darnold when it comes to the offense for the Panthers, but not going to go there. Really like Christian McCaffrey. Think it's going to be the cheapest you'll get him all season, 8,500. I mean, you know what you're getting from him. You know, bunch of catches, bunch of rushing attempts, bunch of touchdowns. So I really like him, even against the Cleveland defense. DJ Moore, I think he's a pretty solid play as well. Super consistent wide receiver. Do think more accurate Baker Mayfield is going to get in the ball even more. So like him as well. And that's really it. No tight ends on the Carolina side for me. Green Bay, Minnesota. I think I'm going to avoid Aaron Rodgers, even though he's pretty cheap. I just don't think he's going to be throwing the ball a ton to the wide receivers. I think they're going to do also more of a ground and pound with the two running backs. Matt LaFleur said, you know, Aaron Jones and A.J. Dillon are going to split carries. They're more like running back 1A and 1B. There's not really a discrepancy anymore between the two. So really like both of them. Prefer Aaron Jones. I do think he's going to be their leading wide receiver as well as their running back. So 6,700 looks like a great price against Minnesota for Aaron Jones, who should see probably 6-plus targets, and he's going to see like 15-plus rushing attempts. A.J. Dillon will get fed too, so 5,300 looks great for him. Don't trust any of the receivers, even with Lazard doubtful. I just don't know if I can get to any of them. Tanyan, just not for me. You know, I really just only like the running backs on the Green Bay side. Minnesota side, Kirk Cousins does have some upside, 6,100. I don't mind getting there. Running backs, Dalvin Cook, just a little too expensive for me, but does have an upside versus Green Bay. Rather get to the wide receiver, Justin Jefferson. Obviously, going to be super popular, probably the top five highest owned wide receiver on the slate, even though he is $7,800. But I think he's just going to be able to manhandle the Green Bay secondary. Even if Jair is thrown on him, I trust Justin Jefferson. He's going to get his looks. Thielen looks okay. you know, maybe Zaire does lock up Justin Jefferson, then Thielen's going to eat. KJ Osborne, just not for me, only if someone was injured. Irv Smith, you can definitely take a shot on. Everyone's super high on him. He hasn't played yet because he's gotten injured. But $3,400 is pretty cheap for a guy who, you know, will get some looks from Kirk Cousins, so I don't mind taking a shot there. That really does it for me. Giants, Tennessee, no interest on the Giants side. Danny Dimes, not for me. Barkley looks like a solid value play. I just don't trust him against this defense. Yeah, I just don't trust it. Don't trust in the wide receivers. Tight ends, not for me. Tennessee side, love Derrick Henry for obvious reasons. I think he's just going to run all over the Giants, so expect close to 30 touches for him. Really like him at that price. Wide receiver, I do like Robert Woods. He's very low-key on the slate. Don't think a lot of people are going to get to him. 5,600, do think he's going to fill in well for A.J. Brown, so I like him. Burke's not for me. No tight end, so pretty much just Robert Woods and the King for me on the Tennessee side. On these last two games are going to be the most popular on the slate to stack and attack. Super high scoring games, you know, super explosive offenses. Derek Carr looks fantastic, 5,900, has a ton of upside. I know he wasn't the best towards the end of the season, even though they were winning some of those games, but really expect him to step it up with his former college teammate, Devonta Adams, now on the Raiders. So Jones or Jacobs, just not for me. He looks okay. You know, he does have some pass catching upside, rushing upside, but I do think they're going to be more of an air raid offense with the addition of Devonta Adams at 8,100. You know, pretty expensive. No one's really sure how well they're going to gel the first week. You know, what the splits are, or the target splits are going to be when it comes to him, Renfro, and Waller. But I don't mind getting to him. Renfro, just not for me. I do think they're going to prefer throwing to Devontae or Waller. So those two are firmly in play for me with Carr. On the Chargers side, obviously Herbert going to probably be the most expensive quarterback in the slate for good reason. Huge, huge upside, huge, huge arm, electric offense. So really like him at 7,600. Eckler is a guy, once again, who does it all, runs it in, catches a ton of passes. So 8,200 looks pretty solid for him. Wide receiver, Allen and Williams are both firmly in play. I prefer Williams just more for the tournament upside, which he'll probably be more popular for that than compared to Allen, who is more consistent and even keeled. So do as you will with them. I don't think I'm going to get to any of the tight ends for me on the Chargers side. So it's pretty much just running back, Herbert, and two wide receivers, kind of like the Bengals. And then Kansas City, Arizona, rounding out the main slate. We have Patrick Mahomes, 7,700. Do think he's going to go a little under-owned just because Tyreek's gone. I don't think a lot of people are going to be high on him. I do think he'll have some ownership, but I don't think he's going to be the most expensive on the slate. Maybe not even top five. We'll have to see. Clyde Edwards-Hilaire looks like okay value play. You know, he is healthy this year, so maybe he'll get back to his rookie self, but don't think he had to do it. 5,400. Juju going to be one of the most expensive wide receivers on the slate. You know, everyone thinks he's going to have a great connection with Patrick Mahomes, and I'm not denying that, but 5,200 is just too good of a price tag to get from Patrick Mahomes throwing to him as probably the number one wide receiver. You can definitely take a shot on MVS, 4,700. I just don't really see a difference between him being on the Chiefs and him being on the Packers. You know, maybe the Chiefs will target him more, unlike the Packers, but he's just more of a boomer bust guy. Don't mind taking a shot on Mecole Hardman. Do think he's the wide receiver three over Sky Moore, but I just merely only take a shot in Juju. Obviously love Travis Kelce. He's going to be the number one guy like Mark Andrews. I know Arizona's defense has done well against, you know, tight ends, but I mean, they're not going to stop Travis Kelce. Let's be real. And then Arizona, love Kyler Murray, 7,200. You know, coming off an interesting last season, especially an off season where, you know, that clause in his contract about no playing video games and actually watching film. So, you know, really like him at 7,200. James Conner, one of those running backs, you know, there's like maybe 7 to 8 in this league who's really good at rushing the ball as well as catching passes. So at 7K, really like him to pair with Kyler Murray. Marquise Brown going to be super popular, 6,200. Their number one wide receiver. Because Hopkins is suspended the first 6 games, and Rondale Moore got ruled out. So the wide receiver two is technically AJ Green, but I prefer Andy Isabella. I know Andy Isabella is more of a deep threat, kind of a very quick, super fast guy, but at 3K, I mean, he does have some upside in this spot as a, I think he'll probably be the slot guy. So I don't mind getting to Andy Isabella. I mean, he looks pretty solid, 3K. Kyler's going to have to throw the ball to someone, you know. Marquise Brown, Zach Ertz looks pretty solid, but he's questionable as well. So if he doesn't even play, I really think they're going to rely heavily on James Conner and Marquise Brown along with Andy Isabella. So that does it for me today, guys. My favorite plays are probably going to be from, you know, I like to get different, so I'm definitely going to have a lineup or two centered on these last two games, but I think Robert Woods is a very sneaky, low-owned play. Same with the guys from the Chicago side and the Jacksonville Jaguars guys. But I think my favorite play is obviously Lamar Jackson, Mark Andrews, and I think you go the flex of Travis Kelce. I mean, I think it's double tight end is what I'm going to do. I just think it's too easy to get to both of them for their price tags, and they're both the number one options on their team, with both of the number one wide receivers on their teams being traded away or signed away. So I think this is the building block I'm going to go with: Lamar Jackson, Mark Andrews, and Travis Kelce, and go from there. If you guys liked the video, throw a like, comment, subscribe. Do appreciate all the support, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace.